Hallelujah. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to today's pre-service prayers. Is the choir there? I need help with this song. And if choir is not there, everybody will endure my very beautiful voice. Hallelujah.
You are beautiful beyond description. Too marvelous for words.
Too wonderful for comprehension.
Like nothing ever seen
or heard.
Who can grasp your
Father, you are beautiful beyond description. You are just too marvelous for words. You are too wonderful for comprehension, for us to truly comprehend you, O God. You are like nothing we have ever seen or heard. Even when we think we know you or we can predict you, Lord, you come in new waves of glory. Who can grasp your infinite wisdom? That wisdom that is continuous and never ending. Who can truly grasp it? Who can fathom the depth of your love? How deep it is. As deep as the seas are, the depth of your love is greater. As high as the mountains may be, that love you have for us is higher. Who can truly fathom it, oh God? Our human minds are but too small. You are beautiful beyond description. Your majesty is enthroned above. This morning, I just want us to exalt the name of God. If you want to sing, you can sing. If you want to call his names, call his names.
Yes, Lord.
He has the alagbada ino.
He's
the alawotele o.
Thank you, Father God.
He's the ariru ala.
We glorify you.
He's the eleti baroyi.
We praise you,
he's your ba olowo gboboro.
Thank you.
He's the kabiesi awon kabiesi. He's the Oba Kabiosi.
Hallelujah.
He's the mighty God.
Thank you, Lord.
He's the reigning King.
We glorify
he's
you.
He's Alpha
this place, God.
And he's Thank Omega.
You, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
He's a lion and he's a lamb. He's the mighty one of Israel.
Yes, Lord.
He's the one who speaks and things begin to happen. He's the one who sits enthroned above. The Bible says he makes the earth his footstool. Who can truly fathom? Who can fathom the depth of his love for us? For the Lord looks at us and he sees love. He looks at us and he sees the righteousness of Jesus. Oh Lord, you are great. You are kind. You are awesome. You are loving. You're the God who was before time was created. You're the God who is even right now in our present situation. And you are the God who reigns forevermore. Father, we love you.
Love you, Lord.
Lord, this morning, we love you.
We
Because you first loved us with an everlasting love, with an enduring love.
Yes, Lord.
Ah, Father.
Thank
when we take a decision for that love,
for your stubborn love,
you keep us close. You hold us tight. Father, we are grateful for your eternal love. Thank you for your eternal sacrifice. Thank you for Jesus who died, his blood shed. And that is what makes us secure. This morning, we have just come to lift your name high in this place. Because you said if we lift your name high, you yourself will draw men unto you. Ah, Lord, this morning, we love you, Lord. We appreciate you. Thank you for waking us up to see a bright new day. Thank you for watching over us through the perils of the night. For in the night watch, the enemy came severally. But Father, you were with us. You saw us through.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for that miracle of sleeping and waking up. There were those who went to sleep last night but did not wake up today. We woke up today because we are beneficiaries of your grace. We do not boast. We do not think that we are deserving. Rather, we stand and we say thank you.
Thank you, Father.
We say thank you,
for
the
Father,
demonstration of your love in our lives,
hallelujah,
in our homes, in our families.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for that grace that woke
thank
us up
you,
this
Lord
morning.
Jesus.
Thank you. Thank you, Father.
Thank
you. We give you glory. We give you praise. We invite you to this place this morning. Oh God, even as we're gathered here in this place called Unity Hill Chapel, we invite you. We ask for your presence to come down. We ask that we may experience you, oh Lord, like never before.
Amen.
Today is a new day.
Yes,
today is another day.
Yes,
a day that marks the future. Father, we invite you. Come and have your way in our lives. Come and have your way in our midst. We invite you, oh God. Come and take your place. Come and take your place. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
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 Amen. And amen. Jesus is Alpha. Alpha and Omega, oh,
Jesus is Alpha, Alpha and Omega.
So we praise him for his Alpha,
Alpha and Omega.
So we praise him for his
Alpha, Alpha and Omega.
Jesus is Alpha,
Jesus. Alpha,
Alpha
and Omega,
Jesus,
Jesus is Alpha, Alpha and Omega, so we praise him for his Alpha, Alpha and Omega.
Psalm 133 verse 1 to 3, Unity Hill Chapel. Scripture. It says, behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious oil upon the head, running down on the beard of Aaron, running down on the edge of his garments. It is like the dew of Hermon descending upon the mountains of Zion, for there the Lord commanded the blessing. Life forevermore. Thought somebody will shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This morning, we're going to pray with verse 1 and verse 3b. For everyone who has come in early today, the Lord has commanded a blessing for you this week.
Amen.
This month.
Amen.
And this year in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want us to now return God's word back to him using his own words in verse 1 and verse 3b. Verse 1 says, behold how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. And verse 3b says, for there the Lord commanded the blessing. This morning I want to pray, say, Lord, I am here today to worship you in this place called Unity Hill Chapel. I dwell in this place with other brethren, united in our love for you above everything else. You have said in your word that you command the blessing there, in this place, on this altar, O Lord, command the blessing upon my life, upon the lives of our pastors and leaders, upon every life gathered here, upon every family represented here, upon every home, upon every household here today. O Lord, command the blessing Command the blessing, oh God. Command the blessing in the name of Jesus. Lord, it is your word. Now we take it back to you. We are gathered in this place. We are gathered in unity. We are gathered in the purpose of the Lord Jesus Christ. Your love binds us as one. Lord, we ask, command the blessing in the name of Jesus. Lord, let people not just ask us. You go to church every Sunday. You say this is what happens in church. Yes, we do not see the evidence. Lord, the day we ask, command the blessing upon our lives. Command the blessings upon our businesses. Command the blessings upon our jobs. Command the blessing upon our careers. Command the blessing upon our health. Command the blessing upon our lives. Father, we ask upon our children, command the blessing upon our generations yet unborn. Command the blessing. You have said, in this place, Unity Hill Chapel, you will command the blessing. Oh Lord, command the blessing upon us forevermore, life forevermore. Father, we ask in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. We bless you, Lord. You are holy, holy Lord.
And forever you are God.
We bless you, Lord. You are holy.
We bless you, Lord. You are holy.
A special blessing for those who have come early. And he says, put me to test this week concerning that blessing. He says, it is a blessing for coming in early into his presence and that we should put him to test. Amen. Luke chapter 5, verse 1 to 11 tells the story of the four fishermen who Jesus called to become his disciples. But I just want to pick a prayer point from verse 4 to 6, not the whole 11 verses. Verse 4b says, he said to Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch. Verse 5, but Simon answered and said to him, Master, we have toiled all night and caught nothing. Nevertheless, at your word, I will let down the net. And when they had done this, they caught a great number of fish and their net was breaking. This morning, I just want us to close our eyes and form a picture of your own net-breaking miracle. What is that net-breaking miracle that you want? What have you toiled all night over and you have not received any evidence? Many of us, like Peter, we have toiled, we have worked very hard, very, very hard, strategically, focused, putting our all into it, praying, fasting, believing God, all night long. For weeks, months, for some of us, possibly years. There's something that for about 20-something years, for about 20 years, I wanted, but it never came. until this year.
Shut up.
It's a long testimony. It's just one for another day. 20 years. By the time he came, the first thing I said, God, what do I do? When you want something for so long, and then you just leave it in the hands of God, when God brings it in the fullness of time, it happens in a twinkle. We don't have anything tangible to show for all that we have put in. I have your business, career, education, pursuit of one goal or the other. Even our best efforts and intentions, carried out honestly and truthfully, have yielded nothing. Now, with that picture we have formed, we will pray like this. Say, Lord Jesus, your word says, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch. We say we launch our nets into the deep. We trust your word to come to pass in our lives. We launch out. We launch out. We launch out, oh Lord, into the deep. Into the deep. Into the deep. We do not rationalize or try to understand or try to process why the previous times we launched out didn't yield desired outcome. No, no, no. This time around, we pray in faith. We hold your word back to you and we launch out in the name of Jesus. Give us a great number of fish, a great number of catch, our own great testimony, our own great evidence that your word works, our own confirmation of our faith in you. Lord, let our nets this morning, let our nets burst at the seams. Let our catch cause our boat to begin to sink. Let our net breaking miracle cause others to look and begin to ask, how did you do it? Then we will say, Jesus did it. This morning, let us take it to him. We're not going to doubt that this time, it might not work. That's the devil whispering to us. Let us extend and stretch our faith. Launch out into the deep this morning. Make that demand. Make that demand. We're in the place of his presence. We're in the place of his power. There's nothing that is impossible to him. Father, we thank you. Because we know that this time around, we will testify.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you because we know that this time around, shame is removed.
Amen.
From our lives.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
1 Kings chapter 18. From verse 20 to 39. You can go and read that at home. I'll just bring out some prayer points from there. Verse 30, this is about Elijah's Mount Carmel victory. Verse 30 says, then Elijah said to all the people, come near to me. So all the people came near to him, and he repaired the altar of the Lord that was broken down. Let us pray that if there are any altars in our lives, which we have broken down, or which was broken down due to our carelessness, that by the help of the Holy Spirit this morning, we repair them, we repair them, we repair them. Begin to tell God, every altar in my life that is broken down, either by my own hands, or by my ignorance, or by my not being aware of them, altars that you expect to be in place, this morning, Lord, I repair them. By the help of your Holy Spirit, I repair them, oh God.
Yes,
I repair them. I repair them in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us pray for our homes. Let us pray for our families. Let us pray for our church members. Let us pray for our leaders, our pastors in church, that every broken altar, broken knowingly or unknowingly, should be repaired today in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray. Father, come and repair every broken altar in our lives. Come and repair every broken altar in the lives of our spouses. Come and repair every broken altar in the lives of our children. Broken altars in the life of our parents, grandparents. Lord, come and repair today. Broken altars in the lives of our siblings, in the lives of our nieces and our nephews, in the lives of our friends and loved ones. Father, come and repair today. Every broken altar in the lives of everybody connected to us. Father, we pray this morning, come and repair, come and repair, come and repair it, come and repair it, like you did for Elijah on Mount Carmel. Come and repair these broken altars. We need these altars to be set in place in order for your presence to be going and coming in those altars. Thank you, Father, because you know that as we have prayed today, you have done it in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. When I was preparing this Elijah's Mount Carmel victory, a prophecy came and said, the altar needs to be repaired. What men have broken down with their own hands? What men have caused to happen at moments of disregard for God Almighty? The altar needs to be repaired. Hallelujah. Elijah used 12 stones to represent the 12 tribes of the sons of Jacob to rebuild the altar. We too this morning, as spiritual Israel, we adopt 12 everlasting stones and rebuild every altar that is broken in the mighty name of Jesus. Verse 33 to 35, he commanded that a total of 12 water pots be poured on the sacrifice, drenching it through and through, totally soaking the bull, the wood, the trenches with water. Then he called down fire on the sacrifice, on the already drenched altar. It is difficult enough to light a match and set a whole bull on fire with the flame of one match without using accelerant or combustible materials. Some issues of life that we hear about are just like this sacrifice. They are such that we have overdrenched with water. We have used our own hands, our own actions, our own inactions, our ignorance, our pride, to make them worse than they should be. It has now become impossible to make fire burn the sacrifice. By our own hands, we have made an already impossible situation worse. Yet, to completely defeat and gain victory over these prophet or Baal situations disturbing our lives, we need fire to fall. No human-made matches of fire can save the situation. We need the spirit of Elijah to call the fire down from heaven. And this morning, we're just going to sing and the fire will come down. I want us to believe that those prophet of Baal situations, that came to Elijah on Mount Carmel, they were making fun of him, making fun of his God. They were laughing at his commitment and diligence in the house of God. Because they hadn't seen the power of God for so long, they were making light of the power of our God. We are facing all those kind of situations. Some of them, we even contributed to why they refused to burn. This morning, we're going to call down that Mount Carmel fire in this place. Send down fire, Holy Ghost fire, in this place this morning. Send down fire again, Holy Ghost fire. Send down your fire, Lord. Send down fire, Holy Ghost fire.
Send down fire again.
We're going to take that song with a faster tempo, please. Lord, I'm sorry. Please, let's take that song with a faster tempo, like a marching beat. Okay? You know, like...
Send down fire. Holy Ghost fire. Send down fire. Holy Ghost fire.
Send down your fire, Lord.
Oh,
fire.
Yes, Lord.
Thank
yes,
you
Lord.
Because we have had a Mount Carmel fire experience, oh God. Thank you because tongues of fire have descended upon us in this place today.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. Thank you, Father, for visiting those situations that are dead. Thank you, Father, for every Lazarus type situation that was dead and stinking. You have visited this morning. Thank you that you have made it alive. Ah, Father, when Jairus' daughter died, people said she was just sleeping. Hey, they didn't understand. So when Lazarus died, you waited. You waited for the 4 days so that he would be stinking, so that you could prove to those people that you are God Almighty. So it is as well for us today. Every situation that is drenched with water, every situation that is hopeless, every situation that cannot be recovered, Father, we recover it back today in the name of Jesus. Every hopeless situation, we turn it around in the name of Jesus. Every dead and stinking situation, we prophesy life to it today in the name of Jesus. Lord, we hold on to you. We will not leave this place today until you bless us. Bless us, oh God. Bless us, oh God. Command a blessing in this place today. Command a blessing in this place today. Oh Lord, command a blessing upon this altar, upon the altar of Unity Hill Chapel. Command a blessing in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, O Lord. Thank you. Thank you, O God. We give you thanks. We give you thanks. We exalt your holy name. Lord, we come in today's service unto your hands. We ask, O God, let your power flow. We pray for the choir and everyone who will be ministering upon this altar. Father, Lord, let them do it in your power. Let them do it in your strength. Let us not minister from the place of man, but from the place of the Spirit. Father, we ask that for everyone who is appointed to be here today, wherever they may be, we ask that you draw them. Draw them, O God. If they are still sleeping, Lord, wake them up. Wake them up and bring them into this place because they have a divine appointment with you. Father, draw souls into this place of your purpose, this place of your power, this place of your life. This place, O God, where you dwell. Lord, this morning we pray. If there's anybody who has come in here today with a burning prayer point, we lay it before your throne. We lay it before your majesty. We ask that, Father, touch that prayer point.
Amen.
Touch that prayer point.
Amen.
Touch that prayer point.
Amen.
That aching heart. Touch that aching heart.
Amen.
Father, Lord, that weary soul. Touch that weary soul.
Amen.
Give us strength.
Yes,
re-energize
Lord.
Us from the inside.
Yes, Lord.
In
yes,
the
Lord.
Name of
yes,
Jesus.
Amen.
Let life not defeat us.
Yes,
let the prophets of Baal not look at us and make fun of us. Let all they do
yes,
not
Lord.
Even touch us.
Yes,
in the name
Lord.
Of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father,
you,
because
Father,
we know that you are with us.
Yes,
we give you all the glory.
Hallelujah.
Return all the power and praise to you.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
I'll now invite the Unity Hill Chapel Choir.
Praise the Lord. Somebody praise the Lord. Scripture declares in the book of Psalm 98, verse 1, it says, "Oh, sing a new song unto the Lord, for he has done marvelous things. His right arm and his holy arm have gotten him the victory." So this morning we have a simple song, a new song. We're going to learn, we're going to sing to the Lord a new song this morning. I'd like us to just, you know, sing the song together. All right. This song says, it says this.
Lord, you are awesome.
Can you sing with me? Come on.
Lord, you are awesome.
Can we take that part again? Come on.
Lord, you are awesome.
Come on, people of God, come on.
Lord, you are awesome.
Let's sing it one more time. Lord, you are awesome.
Lord, you are awesome.
We'll take it one more time.
Lord, you are awesome.
Then it says this.
If it wasn't for your love,
it wasn't for your grace. You say,
if it wasn't for your love, wasn't for your grace.
If it wasn't for your love, wasn't for your grace. You say,
if it wasn't for your love, wasn't for your grace.
I don't know where I'd be without you. I don't know where I'll be.
I don't know where I'll be without you.
Okay, can we do it together from the top? Let's go.
Lord, you are awesome. Lord, you are awesome. Oh, Lord, you are awesome.
We'll take it two more times.
Yay! Lord, you are awesome.
Everybody, just open up your mouth and sing to the Lord.
Lord, you are awesome.
So we say,
if it wasn't for your love, it wasn't for your grace.
Let's go.
If it wasn't for your love, wasn't for your grace.
I don't know.
I don't know where I'll be.
All right, let's go. Everybody raise your voice and say,
Lord, you are awesome.
Yeah, beautiful, beautiful. Come on.
Lord, you are awesome.
If you know that our God is awesome, just lift your hands and worship him.
Lord, you are awesome. Receive glory, honor, and praise.
Honor and praise.
Every knee will bow. tongue confess.
Every tongue.
One more time. Every knee will bow.
Every knee will bow down.
Every
tongue
and say.
And say.
And worship. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen.
So every knee will bow down and every tongue confess and say, Hallelujah. Is that your testimony in the house? Every knee will bow down and every tongue confess and say, Hallelujah. Can we just sing that song together? Every knee will bow.
Every knee will bow.
And worship to the King. His Majesty ends. Hallelujah. Come on, this is the moment of worship. Let the Lord hear your worship. Come on. Every tongue confess. Every tongue confess. Hallelujah. One more time. One more time, let the saints lift their voices and say,
every knee will bow,
every tongue confess and say, Hallelujah, Hallelujah. You Oh God, this is your moment of worship. Come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah. He has won it all. You have won it all. Hallelujah. That holds you tight. You are the risen King. And you see that, see that in my oh, you are the same King. Say that could not hold you down. Jesus said to the Jews, destroy this temple And in 3 days, I would raise him. He's the only one that died and rose again. And today he is seated in heaven. And the earth, Bible says that the earth is his footstool. He says, behold, I have with me the keys of death and of hell. And he has given you and I the victory. He's seated in majesty. He's seated in majesty. Yeah, my boss. Nothing is too hard. Yeah, my.
Our God is risen. He is alive. His wonder victory. He reigns on.
Can you lift your hands and say, our God is risen?
Our God is risen.
Yes, he's alive. He's no longer in the grave.
He is alive.
The tomb is empty. He reigns. Somebody say, our God is risen. Jesus is risen. Jesus is risen. He's won the victory.
He's won the victory.
He reigns. Bible says he was given a name that is above every other name, that at the mention of the name of Jesus every knee will bow and every tongue declare that Jesus is alive. Our God is risen.
He is alive.
He's won the victory. I see you, Jesus.
His wonder victory, he reigns on high.
Hallelujah. Our God is risen. He reigns on high. He's the God that we bow to. He's the God that we call upon. Let us open our mouth and just praise him and give him all the thanks, because he's God. He reigns on high. No one can compare with him. No one can be like him. He's God. Above all gods, he's the Alpha, the Omega, the Omniscient One, the Omnipotent One, the I Am that I Am, the Jehovah Nissi. He reigns on high. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you, Almighty God. We give you all thanks, O Lord. The Bible says in 1 John 1:7, it says, but if we walk in the light, as is the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. Let us come to service this morning, knowing that as we partake in the communion, every part or affliction or sin or anything that is in us that is not of God will be cleansed away in the name of Jesus. Everything that is not of God, that is lurking in our family line, that is lurking in any generation, Father Lord, today as we partake in the Holy Communion service, we say, Father, cleanse us, O Lord. Cleanse us, O Lord. Purify us, O Lord. Wash us clean, O Lord. Sanctify us, O Lord. Consecrate our hearts and our spirits. Let us only align with your will. Let us be dead to flesh. And more of you, O Lord, less of us, Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray this morning. Amen. Welcome, everybody, and please be seated. Thank you, Unity Hill Choir. Unity Hill Chapel would like to warmly welcome everyone. Welcome to today's Holy Communion service. As we come, I know that you've all come with a heart of gratitude and a heart that is prepared to receive from God today. So let us come into the Holy Temple knowing that today is a day that God has set us aside to be purified and used by Him in Jesus' name. It's great to see everyone. And we pray that whether you are online or physically here, you'll be blessed by the service in Jesus' name. For all our online worshipers, please prepare your elements in advance. You can use wafers, bread, or crackers with grape juice, wine, or water for the Holy Communion. For our teens, it's time to get up and go straight to your hangout. We have a new place for you this morning. The ushers are around to take you to the new place. So please make sure you enjoy it. It's been prepared for all of you. And your teachers are waiting to receive you. Our teen hangout holds on Sundays here at TCC. And it's a hybrid meeting. So for those online, please log into the service and join. It's open physically and both for those online as well. Please remember that you can use the bulletin. There's an envelope on your seat. And then there's also a QR code that would appear on the screen. Please remember to scan it so you can have access to all the today's hymn, Bible reading, notice for the week, and also the church account details for offering. It's much easier to follow the hymns that way, especially if you sit at the back. But for those of us that don't wear glasses, we can still try and see. Now, please remember to go to the ushers if you have any issues with the scanning on the QR code. And thank you once again, and welcome to church. We'll now take the first hymn.
May we please rise for the first hymn, Amazing Grace. Thousand years.
morning, church. Okay, so I shall be taking the announcements for today. Are there any first-timers with us today? Any first-timers? Anyone who's been away for a long time? I'm trying to source you out. So no first-timers. So welcome to church, everybody. Okay, since there are no first-timers, can we welcome ourselves at least? Oh, where? Oh, sorry, the light's blocked. Where? Oh, sorry. Sorry. Okay, so the ushers, please, the ushers will hand over a card. Right after the service, there'll be a little reception for you on my left, also on your left, on your way out. We'll just meet with you for about 5 minutes to get to know you better. You're welcome. So can we welcome ourselves, please? Service, we can carry on. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so Tuesday midweek service, Tuesday midweek Bible study, sorry, carries on every Tuesday. This coming Tuesday, the focus scripture is 2 Timothy 1, 7. Can we be seated, please? 2 Timothy 1, 7. Usually we advise you read ahead of time because it's an interactive study time. The topic is fear and faith, and it carries on. It goes on from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. If you're not receiving our WhatsApp messages or emails, it means we don't have your details. Please leave your details at the admin desk. For those who receive it, the link to this midweek service is posted on the WhatsApp group. On Tuesdays and Thursdays, we have our usual morning prayers from 6 o'clock to 6:30 a.m. We encourage people to join to start your day, 6 o'clock to 6:30, Tuesday and Thursdays. Next Sunday, we have our service here as usual. Please invite your friends and family. I believe most people have returned from the summer, so the hall is looking full now. But please invite your friends and family. For the Discipleship Academy Module 1 training, it was supposed to have held, I think, in August. So please note the change of date. It's now going to start on October 26th, but run through to November 30th. Please note October 26th to run through to November 24th, November 30th, 2024. For the registration, please carry on, you know, if you're interested, please carry on registration. There's no delay in there's no postponement in the registration, I hear. The registration carries on as usual. So please register. It's free. It's physical. The locations will be announced when you are registered, but it is mandatory that you register so we prepare for the numbers, I'm correct. Okay. So, and that will hold on Saturdays, by the way, from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. There's a vacancy, IT officer at Unity Hill Chapel. We're looking for an IT officer. An ideal candidate would be someone that has a BSc degree in computer science or any related field, 1 to 3 years work experience. The responsibility is to support the IT and media team, to support software maintenance, hardware, land support and maintenance, and to manage the church's website. If I believe it's a paid role, if I'm correct. So it's a paid role, it's not for volunteers. So if you know anyone interested, or if you're interested, please submit your CV to admin. And then now we need the volunteers. I'm sure we've been announcing this for like 4 months, but we need volunteers for the LED screen operator, easy worship operation, photography, videography, sound technician, sound engineer, operations support. Even if you are inexperienced in these areas, we are willing to train. So please, I think it's gone on for like 4 months, so it tells me that people are not really volunteering. So please, you know, please, it's the work for the Lord. Please volunteer. Now it's for our tithes and offering. If you'd like to give, there are various ways to give. I think, yeah, that's posted online. So your envelopes also on the seats. If you put anything in the envelopes, please don't leave it on the seat. There are boxes on your sides. You can also give it to an usher. You can do a bank transfer if you want to, and the POS machines are at the back if you choose to use your cards. I'll just give a few seconds for people who are giving at the moment. So let's pray for our offering. Father Lord, we thank you. We thank you for the opportunity to once again give up to you. We thank you, Father Lord, that we are here by your grace, Almighty One, and we are able to give by your grace. For those who are willing to give, but Father Lord, and unable to, we ask that you open doors for them. Father Lord, surprise them, Almighty One. Put things in their hands, Almighty One. Let those willing hearts be able to fulfill their desires. And for those who have given, Almighty One, Father Lord, we thank you. You will replenish your pockets, Father Lord, Almighty One. They will never look and ask or beg. They would always be givers. We give you all the glory, and we say, Father Lord, this contribution, Father Lord, will be used to your glory alone. Father Lord, Almighty One, you will direct every expense, and you will direct every spending of this giving. We thank you for all you have done thus far. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Amen. The choir will now minister a song taken from the words of the 12th chapter of Isaiah, after which we would have Pastor Tolu take the sermon. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Oluyede. Good morning, church. Good morning, church. The Bible reading for today is taken from Isaiah 12, 1 to 6. Isaiah 12, 1 to 6. I will be reading from the New King James Version. And in that day you will say, O Lord, I will praise you. Though you were angry with me, your anger is turned away and you comfort me. Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. For Yah, the Lord, is my strength and song. He has also become my salvation. Therefore, with joy, you will draw water from the wells of salvation. And in that day, you will say, Praise the Lord, call upon his name, declare his deeds among the peoples, make mention that his name is exalted. Sing to the Lord, for he has done excellent things. This is known in all the earth. Verse 6, last verse. Cry out and shout, O inhabitants of Zion, for great is the Holy One of Israel in your midst. Hallelujah.
Oh. I will draw from the wells of salvation.
joy I will drink, and I'll never thirst again.
Lord, you are my strength.
Lord, you're my strength.
Called the wells of salvation. It never runs dry. You know, every time in scripture, or many times, when they want to illustrate the presence of God or the move of the Holy Spirit, water is always used. It says there was a time in Ezekiel, say from the throne room of God, water came out, and everywhere that water went, there was healing. Everywhere that water went, there was productivity. Everywhere that water went, it brought peace to the souls of the people. So when we pray for a service like this, we pray that the rivers will flow here, that the water will terminate here, that it will not be a church service as usual, that it will be a church where there's the touch of God, a service where the angels move in our midst, where everybody will go and believe that I took something home. Where even if you come burdened, there's a peace of God that will surpass all understanding that just comes upon you. Please, don't let's make church a mechanical gathering, but at every engagement that the Spirit of God is moving. And I pray today, everybody will feel the touch of the Almighty. As God is going around giving us to drink of Himself, that all of us will be filled with the Spirit of God. And everything that's an issue in our life, we will have answers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Unity Hill Chapel Choir, God bless you. You know, as I was coming up, a psalm just came to mind, verse 1 of Psalm 63. It says, "Oh God, you are my God." But when David writes like this, he has reached a situation in his life where people will say, "You've reached your tether's end." You know, and he says, "Oh God, you are my God. Early will I seek you. My soul, it thirsts for you. Even my flesh is longing for you in a dry and thirsty land where there is no water." This water is about, I can't feel your presence. Why is my soul burdened? Some people have everything in the world. They still don't have rest. I'm praying this morning, you will have rest. Anyone you pray for will have rest. And remember, there are sometimes, even in scripture, in gatherings, people have gone to church not because they know God, not because there's an echo. Not because they know God, and not because they've come to meet God specially. But even for those people, we find that God touched them. So I'm praying today God will touch all of us. I asked someone the other day, you come to church all the time. Why do you live this kind of lifestyle? Why won't you fully surrender your life to Christ? He said, I will do it. What are you waiting for? I pray that today the Spirit of God will convict you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. You know, as human beings, can you give me the hand mic? Because this is, I'm sorry, it's just coming back. I don't know if you can hear it. It's coming back into my head. So I can't hear myself properly. Thanks. Thank you. But you fixed it. I'll still hold it. Just like sending this young man on an errand. That's how you got him standing here last week for 30 minutes. So as human beings, you would have times that are high. You have times that are low. You know, there are all sorts of things that might be bothering us, and there are various reasons. So when we engage people, people would say, I just feel abandoned. And it's maybe they were abandoned by people, or even someone said, I feel abandoned by God. Why is everybody getting this? I am not. Why is it so late? Some people feel stressed. Some people feel fearful. Some people feel left alone. And some people would say to you, I feel spiritually dry. I used to wake up and pray every morning, but I just don't do it again. I don't know why. Some people will say, I come to church, I see people raising their hands, I just don't connect. That's what we call being spiritually dry. That means that the things of God are happening and you're not partaking of it. You're not sensitive to the Spirit of God. So people just come into that place. But we learn from God that if you're in that space, there is help for you. We learn from scriptures that we can obtain succor and strength from God. He created us. He shouldered the responsibility of our salvation, of our well-being. And that's why, inspired by God, Isaiah wrote the second verse of the Bible reading today, Isaiah 12, verse 2. He said, behold, God is my salvation. God is your salvation. He said, I will trust and not be afraid. And that's the promise this morning. He says, the Lord is your strength. The Lord is your song. When you sing with a heart of rejoicing because God has made you to sing that song. And then he repeats it again. The Lord is my salvation. We know what salvation means generally. Deliverance, protection from rain, from harm, from situations. You're just delivered from that thing that's making you lose your joy and your peace. And then spiritually or theologically, deliverance means that you're delivered from the consequences of sin, that God has just forgiven you. We can also sing that song. So when I read this Isaiah 12, and I read it when I'm in those situations, yes, I get in those situations sometimes. When I read it, I also sing some of those songs. Or maybe I play them and I sing along. And then I get this soothing of my spirit. Maybe we can just take that part of that verse where it says, the Lord, I will praise you. I will trust and not be afraid. And I will sing unto you. From the wells of salvation.
I will draw from the wells of salvation. With joy I will drink, and I'll never thirst again.
You are my strength. visualize myself as drawing from those wells. You know, they use well and water to depict that it doesn't have an end. If I call it wells, you're just drawing from it. You can even start crying after a while because you have seen that God have come to you. I'm drawing from your wells of salvation where I can be delivered. You know, we understand from the book of Isaiah that God has then provided for this salvation for us in our Lord Jesus Christ, which is why he sent him. And he prophesied in Isaiah long before Christ came, Isaiah 11 verse 10. He says, in that day, the heir to David's throne will be a banner of salvation to all the world, talking about Christ. The nations will rally to him, and the land where he lives will be a glorious place, which means everywhere the presence of God is glorious. I personally believe this morning that where we are gathered, the presence of God is there. This place is a glorious place this morning. As I'm speaking and you're praying under your breath, I pray that the Spirit of God will work on your prayers this morning, that you will not be church as usual. And as we take communion, I pray that you'll change something in our lives for good. And then it continues the first verse of chapter 12. He says, in that day you will say, O Lord, I'll praise you. Though you were angry with me, your anger is turned away, and you comfort me. What he's saying is that when Jesus comes, which is the New Testament now, he says all our sins are forgiven. God will just not punish you for anything. Even if you ask for forgiveness, he might not punish you for the consequences of your sin. But you might just be chastised and disciplined for bad behavior. But when that happens, when things begin to happen, stop saying the devil has done something. The first thing you do is you look inward. What is it that I used to do I'm not doing anymore? Or what can I be doing better? I spoke to someone last week when we were fellowshipping. I was asking him, what are those things that you thought you were holy and righteous before? Right now, things are not before. He said to me, this social media thing can be good and bad. He said, there are things I used to look at, and when I see, you know, on Facebook, I'll delete. But he said, now I stay 1-2 minutes on them, if you know what I mean. And that 1-2 minutes, I've gone to 5 minutes, 6 minutes. His spirit is defiled. So we pray together. I said, well, it's happened to me before. There's some of them you can press cross and they never come back. He said he has done them. They still keep on coming back. A defiled spirit makes it difficult for God to speak to us. God likes vessels that are sanctified. So anything in your life that you believe doesn't glorify God is going to hinder your prayers. We have to draw from the wells of salvation because that's where deliverance is. So you go to God and say, can I draw the strength that will make me to stop doing this thing? Speaking to someone last month, telling me that 10 years ago he used to abuse, physically abuse who he was living with. He thought he was delivered. 12 years later, he started abusing again. That's his stronghold. So I said, by the grace of God, salvation will come to you. And we are still holding hands now, and I'm praying that that will never happen again in Jesus' name. So when we need help, we are told to go to Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is described as carrying or harboring these wells of salvation. The plural is just that it doesn't have no end. Verse 3. So it says, with joy we will draw from the wells of salvation, Isaiah verse 12, where we go to find never-ending supply of restoration, refreshment, and hope. As you have come today, you've come to God, you've come to the wells of salvation. Please, children of God, don't fear about the future. Nigeria might look the way it is, things might look the way they are, but you know what? The Nigeria of today, some people have been suffering it for 30 years. It has just arrived at the step of some of us, and we have shaken. But God has kept those people. God will keep you. God will keep you. And all these prayers we are doing for Nigeria, we believe that they will come to pass. Nigeria will change in our time. A deep, whatever you need is in that well. Sorry. You don't have to go anywhere else. Everything is in God. In John 7, Jesus affirmed that it was him whom Isaiah was speaking about, verse 37 to 39. He says, on the last day, the great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, if anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. This message is a message of which I'm calling people to come and dedicate yourselves to Christ if you have never done it. But I'm praying specifically for some people. It's a time for rededication. Some of us are backslidden. We don't even know that we are enjoying the life that we are living. With the Spirit of God here today, I pray, even as we breathe in and out, we will breathe in the Spirit of God because we are at the well this morning. He said, if anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, as the Scriptures have said, out of his heart will flow rivers of water. But this he spoke concerning the Spirit, saying, it's the Spirit that I will give to you. It's like he was saying, Jesus has these bowels of mercies that can never dry up. Ephesians 1 verse 23 says, and the church is his body. It's made full and complete by Christ, who fills all things everywhere with himself. There's no life out of Christ. Everything you want is in him. We have to deliberately or consciously go to that fountain. You know, what we are doing this morning is we are deliberately coming to the fountain. But I also want you to visualize that rivers are flowing, that Jesus is here, salvation is here, wells are here. All you have to ask is, God, give me a drink. Give me a, you know that song we always sing, fill my cup, Lord? That's what it means. Give me a drink. There was a song, I don't know if you can help me, choir, when I first got born again, and please don't ask me how long. He says, I am thirsty, Lord. I am thirsty, Lord.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
I am thirsty, Lord, for the living waters of life. Is there anyone thirsty this morning?
Well, I want a drink.
Yes.
Yes, I want a drink.
Yes, I want to drink of the living waters of life.
Fill me up, Lord.
Fill me up, Lord. I don't have to feel it. Lord, make me drunk with your Holy Spirit. I'm tired of whispering. Shouting, I don't want a cup, Lord. Give me a fountain. I'll take another drink.
I'll take another drink.
I'll take another drink of the living waters of life.
I saw one or two people singing that song. I can tell your age. So we used to sing it in those days. You know, when we went to start fellowship, we just started singing this song. Before fellowship starts, we are drenched. We are saying, God, give me another drink. So fellowship wasn't mechanical. Every fellowship was about, God, come and move inside of me. I'm just praying today, you will not just be a nominal Christian. You know, we prayed the leader's prayers this morning. That everybody in this church, your prayer will avail so much. When they call you to pray for people, you will not be afraid. When you lay hands on people, you are believing that something will happen. Not only the pastor. So in the Hill Chapel, you will be seen as a church of people filled with the Holy Spirit. You will be drinking. Anybody praying all these songs in your cars, you are driving, you are drinking from the Holy Spirit without realizing. How can you even have a terrible boss? You are going to work. You are not playing spiritual songs. You can't conquer. When you leave work, you might play something else. As you are going in, child, you must begin to. Yeah. So this well of salvation is a place for many things. Many things. And one of them, I'll talk about three or four of them this morning before communion. And one of them is a place of conversion. A well of salvation, where we are today, is a place of conversion. It's a place where you go to Christ and you say, I surrender my life to you. And Christ then says, I accept you. I give you a drink, which is the Holy Spirit. If you have never been to the well for the Holy Spirit, I encourage you this morning. If you say I'm a Christian and your life never changed, you have not received the drink yet. So I encourage you this morning, as we take a step forward, that you ask that God will come and give you that drink that never runs dry. This is what happened to the lady at Samaria. Some of you might know that story. The lady went to the well to drink and met Jesus at the well. Jesus, knowing where he was going with the discussion, asked the lady, can you give me a drink? The lady looked at Jesus and said, I'm Samaritan. You are a Jew. We don't talk to each other. Why are you talking to me? And Jesus just went right to the question. He says, if you knew who was talking to you, that's verse 10 of John 4. If you know who was talking to you, you will ask that he'll give you living waters to drink. Waters that will never run dry. And as he said that to the lady did not understand, but he was saying, I'll give you water to drink that you receive peace that passes all understanding. You see, Jesus understood the problems of that woman. She had married a few husbands. And she was now looking for another one because all the ones she had married, they did not satisfy her. So Jesus was saying, there's nothing wrong with drinking physical water, but ask me for this drink. Even if you don't have a man, you'll still be satisfied because I'll be filling you up. And he even says, when I give you this drink, your perspective to life will change. Even the kind of man you are looking for will change. Because this drink changes you completely. So at the well is a place of conversion. And I'm praying this morning, God will convert, will make his spirit to convict some people so they'll be fully converted. You know, it's known in Christianity that we have so many half-converted people. If you go to a church, I read one research, it said fully converted is like 20%. Half-converted, between 20 and 80%, just coming to church. He said, that's the most of them. Then you have 5 or 10%, they just came to steal. They just came to find a way to lure you away from God. Especially those of you who are looking to marry and somebody keeps on following you to church. I've told some of you before, someone courted 1 year. They went for counseling. I don't know who I told. And the counselor, after 4th session, Mr. Man, every time we pray, we say you pray, you never say in the name of Jesus. And the guy said, oh, there are many ways to God. They had courted for almost 2 years. All he was just waiting is, let's marry. I like the behavior of this person, submissive, full of the Spirit, and was working on this person. I pray that as we drink this morning, God will reveal to us things that nobody else can see. Amen. Unfortunately, when you are counseling people, you don't even need physical, spiritual eyes to see. You can see, but they don't want to see. You know? You say, well, I like this man you are going out with. Ah, you two say, nice person. Is he married? Oh, I don't know. At 39. So you don't want to ask what you don't want to hear. Is he a Christian? Well, said he was born. When last did he go to church? I will ask him. Because you don't want to hear. And I said, God did not reveal it to me. God help us that we don't have to write a questionnaire. And believe, this is not necessary for marriage relationships. It's big in business partnership. Very big. Don't go and yoke with people who should not. Don't go and yoke people who should not yoke with. You know, they say that you only know your friends when money exchanges hands. Say, take this, keep for me until the next time. You now say, all that time I was running around to CAC. Don't you know this is my money I was spending? This one is not your own anymore. God help us. I'm sure there's nobody in Tihill Chapel that's like that. Yeah. So the well of salvation is a place where faith is boosted. It's also a place where you receive spiritual strength. You know, Isaiah 40, verse 29, as you have come this morning, I'm just trying to encourage us that when we come to church, we should come expectant. It says, God gives power to the weak, and for those who have not might, he increases their strength. What are you weak about this morning? What is making you feel tired? God will give you strength in Jesus' name. I like verse 31. It said, those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. That means you've been to the well. I just don't have time this morning. If you know what happened to Elijah the prophet, the guy was tired. He was even cursing God. They just sent him some food and drink. They said he went for days. That's the strength from God. It's spiritual food. It's manna. The wells of salvation, they're also a place of comfort. Matthew 11, 28. For those of you who are overwhelmed, he said, come to me, all you are weary and heavy laden. I will give you rest. And finally, before communion, the well of salvation is a place of refreshing. It's a place of refilling. Ephesians 5, 5, verse 18. This is one of those scriptures that some of my Christian friends don't like reading. They just skip over it very quickly. Do not be drunk with wine. You might say, Pastor is saying don't drink wine again. That's not what I'm saying. If you have an option to go to where they are drinking wine and to go to where there are wells of salvation, pick one. And this happened a lot on certain evenings of the week. I actually don't know why you're laughing. Don't be drunk with wine. Because why? It can ruin your life. That ruin your life is not even that you get drunk and you go and have an accident. It can defile your spirit. Instead, be filled with the Holy Spirit. You know the Greek word of this being filled with the Holy Spirit. Actually, give me verse 19. How you feel the Holy Spirit? What we are doing today? You're singing psalms and hymns, spiritual songs among yourselves, making music. Sometimes when I have fellowship with the leaders, I say to them, today, all of you are going to give me one song each. We are doing this fellowship together. Yeah, wait a minute, not leaders of this church. But some leaders struggle to even find me a song. When some people are laughing, you think it's them. But it's not them. They are laughing about people they know. Singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs amongst ourselves. I keep on telling you. Temi preached one day about his playlist here. These things are very powerful. You are drinking. You are strengthening your spiritual being. And the original Greek meaning of this being filled with the Spirit is actually to be constantly filled. So you're going to that well all the time. I read about a man of God. I hope it's true because I read it online. He said he used to do miracles. And for a while, he took his foot off the pedal because these things were happening. He wasn't praying like he was praying. Fasting had reduced. He lost it all. He said for 14 years before he started soaking himself, and he calls it marinating himself in Christ. So he said he was going every day to drink from that wells of salvation. And that's why I like how he coins it in verse 3. He says, with joy you will draw. So it's not a passive thing. You are going there to draw on a daily basis. God doesn't meet our needs when we sit in passive inactivity. Worship cannot be on a Sunday thing or a Tuesday thing alone. Yes. In fact, if you really want to drink from the wells, why do you come at 9 o'clock? Prayer starts at 8:30. You want to be blessed. You have to pay the price. Unfortunately, I don't see people who come late again these days. I think it's a gift. So, but today I saw them when I went to the back. And I pray that God will encourage you. You will come early next week in Jesus' name. As we approach the table of communion this morning, let us ask for the living water afresh as we dedicate and rededicate ourselves. Let's ask for the activation of the bubbling of the Holy Spirit that is dormant within us. I pray for you this morning. Sorry. I pray that you give your life to Jesus. Let him fill your soul this morning. Let him take you in his arms and make you whole. As you give your life to him, I pray that he'll set you free and that you'll live and reign with him eternally. Is there anybody here this morning in the presence of God, in the presence of the wells of salvation, that you want to give your life to Christ properly? So I'm not saying you've never done it before. You want to go to the well this morning like that woman in Samaria, and you're saying, I feel like I've never taken from that drink before. I want to properly give myself to you. I denounce every unholy thing I've been doing, and I want to come to you properly this morning with all heads bowed. And I'm not going to call anybody forward. I just want to pray with you. As you raise your hands where you are, God is seeing that you are committing to him. Can you just raise your hand? It doesn't have to be too high. I just want to pray with you this morning that God will move in your life, that the wells of salvation will be something you drink from every day, that your life will change completely this morning. Can you pray with me? Say, Father, I surrender my life to you, my Lord Jesus Christ. I pray for forgiveness of my sins. I repent of them all, and I pray for you to strengthen me that I can remain holy. Pray this morning, say, Father, Lord, let my heart be changed. Remember, the Spirit of God is here. And when you speak this morning, there will be power to your soul. Father, let my heart be changed. Father, let my heart be renewed. Let all my weaknesses be stripped away by the power of your Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. The leaders may collect the emblems now as they prepare for the communion.
I will draw from the wells of salvation. With joy I will drink, and I'll never thirst again. Lord, you're my strength. Lord, you're my strength. So I will draw from the well that will never run dry.
Lord, you are my strength.
Lord, that has troubled my life.
Take communion today. We pray for a fresh visitation. We pray for a fresh touch. We pray for a strengthening of our relationship with God. We pray for power. I pray for healing, and I pray for restoration. I pray for all the hands carrying these emblems to be blessed. I pray that as I've carried this for God, God will shoulder your responsibilities for you. And I pray that as a blessed hand is given to a blessed people, they will receive blessing as well. In Jesus' name I pray. On the night when he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took some bread and he gave thanks for it. He broke it in pieces and said, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. For every time you eat this bread and you drink this cup, you're announcing the Lord's death until it comes." It's also written that we should examine ourselves and repent of all sins before taking communion. This is an advice. If you know you are living in sin, please repent of it and ask for forgiveness before taking communion. It's written in scripture. It says we should examine ourselves so we don't harm ourselves. I bless the bread this morning. Father, Lord, bless the bread that we're about to take. We anoint this bread to be as the flesh of our body, Jesus Christ, of the flesh and body of Christ. Today we partake of the bread. We are declaring that the Spirit in Jesus and divine life flows in our mortal bodies. We pray that we'll be filled afresh with the Spirit that was in Christ when he was raised from the dead. Father Lord, bless this drink they carry as well that we're about to take. Your word says that the life of the flesh is in the blood. We anoint this drink to be as the blood of Christ, the blood that was shed for the forgiveness of our sins, the blood that was shed to overcome all the enemies of our minds and soul. I pray that both the bread and the drink now becomes potent spiritual sacraments in the name of Jesus. We may now distribute the emblems and you wait for me to eat and drink.
Fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul.
Okay, not yet.
Lord, I thirst for you, and I long to be in your presence. My soul will wait on you. Father, draw me nearer, draw me nearer to the beauty of your holiness. Lord, I thirst, Lord, I thirst.
Drink this morning. Say after me. Let your living water flow over my soul. Let your Holy Spirit come and take control of every situation that has troubled my mind. All my cares and burdens, unto you I roll. Hold me in your loving arms and make me whole. Wipe away all doubt and fear, and take my pride. Draw me to your love, and keep me to your side. In Jesus' name we pray. You may now eat the bread. May God bless you as you eat this bread. It bring life to you, bring healing, bring restoration, bring peace, bring joy, bring all the fruit of the Spirit. You may now drink the wine. May this wine be like living waters this morning. It's anointed to be like the blood of Christ. I pray that nobody here will ever be the same again. I pray as we take this bread and wine, healing will come to your bodies. I pray you receive newfound strength of the Spirit, that you'll be able to pray, you'll be able to fast, you'll be able to worship, you'll be able to be sensitive to the things of God. I pray that every burden will be lifted, everything that's contrary to God in your life, God will sort out. For those who wait on God for things, that God will give you a future that is blessed, that God will give you a future that looks great in Him. That concerning you, the kingdom of God will be done. The will of God will be done. Thank you, Father, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Oh, Lord, our God, we thank you for the opportunity to take communion in remembrance of you. I pray, oh God, for the manifestation of the infilling of the Holy Spirit. Say to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, from ages unto ages. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I will worship you, Almighty God, in the beauty of your holiness. I will worship you.
Come on, me.
Almighty
God. Come on, me.
I will worship you.
Thank you very much, Pastor Tolu. The sermon was very good. And I believe that as we have partaken in the communion service, we're living here as living sacrifices to God in Jesus' name. Okay, so we now go to birthdays for the week. We have Peter Fisher on the 11th of August. That's today. Mr. Fisher. Mr. Fisher is around. Happy birthday, sir. And then we have on the 15th of August, Lion Oji. Is he around? Okay. Happy birthday. So we have two people in the house celebrating with us. On the 16th of August, we have Rosalyn Ayamba. She's one of our teachers at Junior Church. On the 17th of August, we have Uche Ajayi, Nathaniel John. Is Uche Ajayi around? Oh, okay. Nathaniel John. Woo! And then we have Nonso Utulu. The choir people. So let us quickly pray for them as they celebrate their birthdays, and especially for the ones that are celebrating their birthdays today. I want to use Psalm 20, verse 4, and I'm reading from New King James. It says, "May he grant you according to your heart's desire and fulfill all your purpose in Jesus' name." I pray that this birthday for each and every one of them will mark the beginning of a year filled with good health, filled with happiness, filled with abundant grace. In the mighty name of Jesus, may your hearts be filled with the light of God, and that as you go forth into the world every day, he will bless you going out, he will bless you coming in, and that he will continue to shower you with his blessings, and the blessings will not be one that will just be now, but it will run from generation to generation for you in the mighty name of Jesus. May you always walk in his light, and that may you always delight in just loving and serving him in the mighty name of Jesus. Just a quick reminder, for the first timers that we have in the service, please remember that we'd love to meet with you after service. So you meet us at the Vicar's Cafe. The ushers will direct you there. It's a place that has been prepared to welcome you, tell you about what we do in Unity Hill Chapel, and know that you are home as you have joined us. For tithes and offering, please remember to drop your envelopes in the boxes at the back. And if you haven't given, quickly click on it now and give. Thank you very much, and thank you for attending service. I'll now hand over to Unity Hill Chapel for the last closing hymn. Jesus, keep me near the cross. Amen.
Please rise for the closing hymn.
Mountains.
This morning is taken from Psalm 63, verses 7 and 8. Because you are my helper, I sing for joy in the shadow of your wings. Verse 8. I cling to you, your strong right hand holds me securely. I pray for you this morning. May God help you in your current situation. May God reveal himself to you and give you peace. May God protect you. May God strengthen you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And we share the grace together. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Go in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. May God be with you all. Amen.